G'day guys, welcome back to the True Footy YouTube channel again. It's your boy Jesse doing yet another tier maker. I'm on an absolute tear with these, so I'm gonna keep going for a bit. In this video, we're gonna be ranking former AFL Rising Star Award winners. I'm not gonna lie to you, there was about two or three that I had to Google because I did not recognize them. But I do know most of them, so I fancy myself at having a good crack at this. Once again, I'm gonna go with the Sabkuda format because, I mean, I know you can edit and put your own like tiers in, but you know, that just becomes too hard to categorize. So I'm just gonna keep it simple. Sabkuda tier for me. So looking down the list, it looks like we have a diverse range of footballers, some well-known and some rather spuddly. Like I always do in these tier maker videos, guys, I'm going to fill the top tier with a couple of names and the bottom tier with a couple of names just so I know what my boundaries are. Straight off the bat, Adam Goods strikes me as absolute tier S quality. Won two Brownlows, absolute champion of the game. I saw today that he said that he fell out of love with the game in his last few years playing footy, and that kind of made me sad because he's such a gun player. Obviously, he was a gun during the Eagles-Sydney rivalry, and I remember thinking he was always the biggest threat, he was the hardest person to stop. So, yeah, absolutely unquestionably in the top tier. Same with Benny Cousins, another player from that same era, won a Brownlow. Could have potentially won a second one had things not been so derailed for him in his personal life, but yeah, I think it goes without saying he is absolute top tier in this list. Now down the bottom, I can't even remember this dude's name. I did Google him. Yeah, I think the fact that I don't know who he is speaks volumes. I want to say his name is Holland, but yeah, honestly, I think he absolutely goes in the bottom tier of this list. Nick Riewoldt, another absolute top tier player. Unlucky not to be a premiership player, of course, but obviously quite a revolutionary style key forward in the way he used to run up the ground. I have no idea who that is as well. I had to Google him. I think his name's Wilson. Yeah, nah, no thanks. We're gonna put him in the top bottom tier. Nathan Buckley, another absolute champion of our game. Brownlow medalist, now coach. But even still, if you're just evaluating it on playing ability, he is top tier, absolutely. Daniel Pearce, I'm gonna put in this column. Is that too harsh? He's significantly better than the other two, had much more of a career, but he just kind of faded into anonymity. I'll revisit that one because it's a bit savage. Brett Deledio, I would say he's an A grader, but didn't quite reach the heights of the guys in the tier below. Tier above. That's obviously your Brownlow medalist slash absolute champions. And he was just a good player throughout the stretch of his career. So in the C column, I'm going to put, it's not a column, it's a tier. I'm going to put Jared Rivers. Again, I don't really remember him that much as a player. I remember he played for Melbourne, went to Geelong, and I think he was a fairly good player. I think he won the Lark medalist. I think that was the most noteworthy thing about him. But he had a solid career, and much like Kaczynski, I'm going to have him in that C column. Kaczynski's a funny one. I don't know if Saints fans rated him more, but I think it was unlucky that he was a number one draft pick because he had a little bit more attention, but I remember he was a bit of a spud, to be honest. So come at me, Saints fans, who probably already hate me. I do have good bants with this this guy called Log Dog in the comments. I'm sure he's watching this going, how can you put Kaczynski in the C? I did put Riewoldt in A grade, mate. So, nah, love your work. Good bants. Joel Selwood, another A grader. Is this contentious? Could I have put him in the top quality? Never won a Brownlow. I don't know. I have him slightly below these guys who are very decorated. Oh, I reckon he's in between. He's better than Deledio, but I don't think he's not on the Cousins, Buckley, Goods level kind of midfielder, in my opinion. But he's not far off. Oh, that's going to be contentious. Daniel Talia, I'll chuck in that A grade. Sort of just a bit of good player for the stretch of his career. I mean, he's still playing. So it's Deledio and Selwood, but still. Byron Pickett, again, this is a little bit before my time, so I don't think I can make a true assessment of him. I think he was just like a good, solid player. So that's why he's in the C column. Didn't actually know he was a Rising Star winner. That's funny. Hazelby goes in the B column. I don't know if non-WA people remember Hazelby being that good. I think he was an understated player. One of those, like, played in an obscure team for a long time, but he absolutely tore up Western Derbies. He was a very good player. As you can see, I've kind of left a lot of the younger players till last because they're going to be the hardest to categorize. Sammy Mitchell probably put in yeah, that's contentious as well. That is very contentious. He and Selwood are probably on a par, but I think he and Selwood are better than Deledio and Talia. But I just don't think they're as good as Goods, Buckley and Cousins, but they were extremely good. Sort of like a Daniel Kerr. If Daniel Kerr was in this list, I'd probably have him here as well. Gee, it's tough. It's tough. But you know what? The list is so talented that it's hard. Reece Palmer, give him a D. Pretty much did nothing after his rising star year. Admittedly, he had an AFL career for most of his like playing life, but played at three clubs, never really any good. Maybe it's a bit harsh, but I think that's where he belongs. Dyson Heppel, put in B. He's a very good player. He's a very good player. And yeah, you'd say he's probably better than Hazelby, but not as good as Mitchell and Selwood. But then he's probably good as Talia and Deledio. This is tough. Do I give in to peer pressure? Do I up these boys to here and maybe go Heppel here? I'm struggling with this one. Is this Chris Scott? It looks like Chris Scott to me. I'll chuck him in the B column because he was a three-time premiership player, I think. I think he played in all three grand finals. He was a very good player, but honestly, it was a little bit before my time, but my impression of him is that he wasn't quite as good as these guys I have in the A column. Jesse Hogan's probably one of the more established players left. Put him in the C column. He did have a very good last year, kicked 47 goals. Pretty average year at Fremantle this year, but sometimes it can be tough adjusting to a new club, new system. I think he's going to improve. I don't think he's going to peter out. And he's still pretty young, especially for a key forward. What is he like, 20? Probably 25 next year. So put him in C for now with potential to bump up to B or A. Absolutely. Daniel Rich, I'll chuck in the B section. Been a very good, dependable player in an average side for a long time. He's very close to All-Australian quality this year. Again, just probably a little bit below the guys in A, but a good solid player over the stretch. I'm liking that phrase at the moment, over the stretch. Louis Taylor will chuck in C. He's a decent player, but I'm pretty sure he's not in their side at the moment. I think he played NEAFL on the weekend. But because he's still playing, I'm reluctant to put him in D. But he's a decent player. Again, he has potential to push up. Hannabury's a tricky one. B or A, I'm thinking. He was so good when Sydney was like relevant and pushing for grand final. I say when they were relevant. It wasn't even that long ago. But again, because of injury, he's kind of petered out. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm being generous here. I'll probably put him around that Heppel level at his best. But he's a shade of the player he once was because he's just so banged up. Amira, chuck in B. Yeah, I think that's fair. He's probably about as good as those players. Potential to go to A, but I feel like his best footballs are definitely ahead of him. Now, this is where the young ones get tricky for me because I'm reluctant to put them too high because I haven't actually proven that much yet. Stevenson seems like a very good player. This is generous. I'm going to chuck him in A. That is very generous because like he hasn't achieved as much as any of the guys here. But I do probably think that's where he's going to end up. McGrath, I'm a little less convinced about. Same kind of criteria. He's a young player who hasn't proven that much yet, other than winning the Rising Star. I feel harsh putting him in C and way too generous putting him in A. Callum Mills, similar sort of thing. I think he's going to be a solid player without being anything too spectacular. But again, it's hard to extrapolate his career. He did have a very good Rising Star year. Particularly as it seems, he is going to be stuck as a defender for a little while longer, it seems. I think if he becomes a genuine on-baller, there's a little bit more potential to go up to here. If you look at the players I've picked in S and A, they're either genuine on-ballers or they're key position players. So maybe a little bit of bias there towards those positions. All right, guys. Well, that is all said and done. As I said, that was a tricky one for me. I feel like there's definitely going to be less consensus than there was in my coach's one. I had a lot of people say the coach's one I got pretty spot on. I feel like this one is definitely going to be divisive. So, as usual, I welcome your comments in the comments section. Tell me what you think. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe for more true football content. Stay tuned also for another True Footy podcast sometime, hopefully later this week. We'll at least record it. And going into the finals, we're going to be ramping up that sort of thing. So stay tuned. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. And if you find any other tier makers or anything like that you want me to do, make sure you hit me up on Instagram or Discord or even in the comments section. Thanks, guys. Bye for now.